You right. introduced a bill to rename a prison in Florida after Trump.
Well, there's a nice federal penitentiary right near Mar-a-Lago. And I just thought, for a guy who's now got 88 criminal indictments pending, criminal, mm-hmm. plus two major civil penalty trials that have already been resolved, costing him about $500 million, I think it's only fitting that if Republicans really want to honor Donald Trump, the most appropriate way to do that is to name a federal prison he might be visiting soon.
Loser, do-nothing members of Congress are wasting everyone's time by engaging in political stunts and deciding on new names for buildings. Now, in this case, you just heard from a House Democrat who wants to rename a prison in Florida after Donald Trump to make a point about his criminal indictments. Ha ha, he he, this is so much fun. But don't worry, I've got a lot of heat for Republicans because they started this naming war. In fact, it all began with a Republican representative, Guy Reschenthaler, who wanted to rename the Washington Dulles International Airport after Donald Trump. The bill actually had, there was a bill, they wrote a bill, Cenk, and it had six co-sponsors, including Paul Gosar. Now, in a statement, Reschenthaler said, as millions of domestic and international travelers fly through the airport, there is no better symbol of freedom, prosperity, and strength than hearing welcome to Trump International Airport as they land on American soil. Now, Dulles Airport, by the way, has been ranked as the eighth worst airport by overall quality in the entire world. This was back in 2015. Priceonomics surveyed almost 17,000 reviews on the airport ratings website Skytrax and found that people not really big fans of the Dulles International Airport. But anyway, more importantly, the bill has zero chance of passing. I can't even believe that any time is being wasted on this. And look, I am really nonpartisan on this issue, okay? There are real problems in the country, and wasting time in naming buildings based on your politically motivated instincts, not really interested in it. It's not cute, I don't think it's fun. And Cenk, I'm just so tired of these people. I hate all of them.
Pausing here to deliver some honest truth as we do in our news coverage as well. TYT is facing challenges, guys, as the entire industry is. You know who could make the difference? You. If you hit the join button below, it's gonna make all the difference and keep us in business. We appreciate you, thank you. So first of all, anybody who flies through Dulles knows Dulles sucks. Second of all, it's kind of fitting that it sucks because the guy who it's named after is one of the worst people, in my opinion, in American history. John Foster Dulles, the only guy worse than him might be Allen Dulles, his brother, who ran the original version of the CIA. John Foster Dulles was Secretary of State for Dwight Eisenhower. These are the guys that carried out coups across the world on behalf of corporations that they and their friends owned.
Right.
So it's, if anything was the deep state, it was the Dulles brothers, okay? So there would be a tiny bit of hilarity, and I'm sure the right wing would enjoy this, of renaming the most deep state named airport into Trump Airport.
Right.
Okay, but it's not like Trump's any better. What does he do? I mean, all he does is tax cuts for the rich and his connected friends and corporations, etc., right after the Dulles brothers' own heart. But the most important point is the one that Anna's making. Who cares about any of this? Are you serious? This is what we're wasting our time on.
Yes.
And to be fair to the Democrats, and we criticize Democrats all the time, as you all know, but the Republicans started this one.
Yeah, they started it. Yeah. It doesn't mean that you go along with it.
No, right? I like strike back.
No, come on, Cenk. No, I think it's pathetic. Oh. And by the way, this is the other thing about the Democratic Party. The criminal indictments is all they care about, all they focus on. And look, I get it. I get that there should be consequences for attempting to overturn the results of the 2020 presidential election. But also, how about you carry out the best interests of the constituents who elected you into office in the first place? And I'm sure that Democratic voters aren't like endlessly obsessed with Donald Trump and owning him. I think they also want policies to pass that would improve their lives. So maybe look into that. So that's why I'm not giving Democrats any credit on this. They should have taken the high road and focused on the policies they could be passing if Republicans in Congress weren't serving as obstructionists in passing those policies.
All I'll say is I believe in strikebacks, so I'm glad that they fought back. And Democrats usually don't fight back. But I agree with Anna that if this whole thing that they say, and Hillary said it the other day again, 91 indictments, wait till people find out.
No, they
brothers
know.
And sisters, they everybody know. Knows about the 91 indictments. You think that they're all gonna wake up out of hibernation and be like, oh, I didn't know he was indicted, now I'm against them. It's just wishful thinking, and it's really sad.
So let's talk about some of the real issues that are just completely neglected by both parties as they waste their time with naming buildings. So I've been talking about this repeatedly on the show, and I want to emphasize again, a lot of Americans are dying every single year now from drug overdoses. So for instance, nearly 108,000 Americans died of drug overdoses in 2022 alone. Over the last two decades, the number of US overdose deaths have risen almost every year and continue to break annual records, making it the worst overdose epidemic in American history. Now, these politicians love to pay lip service to that issue when they're campaigning. And then once they're reelected or elected into office for the first time, they drop the issue because they don't care. Let me give you more. More than 4 in 10 Americans personally know someone who has died of an overdose, and an estimated 13% of the population have had their lives disrupted as a result, according to a new study in the American Journal of Public Health. More than 40 million adults have had their lives disrupted by overdose loss, and an estimated 12.5 million people are still feeling a significant or devastating effect. There's also the issue of corporate greed that goes unaddressed, but I don't think that's an accident. I think that's a feature of our current American Congress. So in the last 3 months of 2023, for instance, after-tax corporate profits reached an all-time high of $2.8 trillion. And that happened as Americans continue to struggle with inflation at the grocery store and in other sectors of the American economy.
Yeah, so we had the culture wars, and as we've explained many times, that was largely a distraction, so you wouldn't notice the $2.8 trillion in profits. And more importantly, I wanna show this graphic seven here, corporate profits after tax, to give you a sense of what has happened in this country. That is the great American robbery. I don't mind corporate profits, great, I'm super happy to have them. But that is them not sharing, okay?
But also, Cenk, I mean, look, let's put that graph up again. It's real important to see where some of the spikes are. One of the biggest spikes occurred in 2020.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, well, so what happened? Who's in charge right now?
Look, the spikes happen under Democrats all the time. And so Reagan began the deregulation. That wasn't for freedom. That was so the corporations can keep a bigger chunk of the pie, right? But Bill Clinton supercharged it at the end of his term. He deregulated the crap out of media, banking, etc. And so, and they started cutting taxes with Reagan. And then through the Democrats, through the Republicans, what do we always tell you on the show? The only thing they actually care about is cutting taxes on the rich and for corporations. And that graph is the perfect example of that. Now we've gone past the culture wars and we have the circus wars. Oh, and hearing about Hunter Biden, let's talk about his penis. Oh, Marjorie Taylor Greene said this, and Lauren Boebert said that, and now the Democrats are gonna name prisons after him. Yes, Queen. All of these circus wars, right? Just to keep you distracted while the corporations are taking all the money and running. That's the great American robbery.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.